name's Tim Hoffman. I am the Director of Quality for Maverick Helicopters, and we're here just talking a little bit about maintenance and our department, give you some details on what it takes to get here, how we do our processes, and what processes we need to accomplish. The facility is approximately 15,000 square feet, and that provides us enough room to work on six aircraft at the same time without having any interference between them. It's a facility that's well lit, it's heated, it's cooled, so that we provide an optimal environment for our technicians to work within. Across all of our locations, we have about 40 personnel that includes support personnel. To try to maintain our fleet of aircraft. My job entails several things. One of them is to keep our maintenance program up to date. I try to develop and maintain systems, policies, procedures, standards, and training programs to make sure that the level of quality here is as high as it could possibly be, so the maintenance goes out the door is 100% every time. We can carry seven people and the pilot all at one time in this helicopter. It also has a slightly elevated seating in the back, so it gives us more of a stadium feel, and there's a lot of transparent panels. One of the main reasons that we do operate it is because it's a wider cabin, so it affords more space for the passengers that are riding within it. So it's just a really good aircraft for trying to do sightseeing or flight scene tours, as we do here at Maverick. A lot of preventative maintenance and inspections that are required, usually on an hourly basis for us, but there's also some calendar components and some cycle limited inspections as well to go along with the components that also need to be replaced on certain intervals or a routine basis. We often take all the parts off the aircraft that won't normally be intervened upon, so we really strip it down and get a good inspection on all areas that might not otherwise be required to be looked at. Well, we're fortunate here to have a good relationship between both our maintenance group and our pilot group, which is something that you don't find at every operation. That helps us be even better at each one of our jobs effectively. If something's going on with an aircraft, the pilot identifies an issue that needs to be addressed, it will communicate it to us directly and tell us what's happening so that we can address any kind of fix that might be required. With that information, we can do troubleshooting if we need to, get into the maintenance manuals to find out if something is within or outside of the allowable limits, and then take action on replacement of that component or do any kind of electrical troubleshooting that might be required to get the process remedied and get the aircraft back flying. We have a great safety record here, and that's not by accident, no pun intended, but really, you have to work towards it. It doesn't happen on its own. So by everybody striving individually to do a great job at their job and be accurate 100% and strive for that high level of safety and quality and maintain that standard, we are going to be successful. Being able to be very good at what we do and not cut corners, take the time necessary, which I think is something that sets us apart as well. We rely on the pilots to do their job to a very high level and do it right every time, just like they rely on us to do our jobs right every time. To be a technician here, you have to have an airframe and power plant certificate issued by the FAA. You can come by this certificate in a few different ways. One of them, most often, an individual will go to a school that is somewhere around 2 years long that's specific to aviation. Then that authorizes them to go take a certain set of written tests and some oral and practical examinations as well. Other ways of getting this certification is going to be through an apprenticeship. So you can apprentice with a willing company that's gonna afford you that opportunity for about 3 years to get both parts of the license, the airframe and the power plant. You get that sign-off letter to go to the FAA. They authorize you to go take the test, both written and the oral and the practical still need to be accomplished. Regardless of the route, you get to that point. That's what you need to do to have that certificate or the A&P to work here at Maverick. Always strive to be better every day. Pay attention to the little things. Try to do them all right and correctly, and it's going to take care of itself after that. But if you're trying to improve yourself at all times, I think that lends itself to hard work, and work ethic, I think, is important to be able to be successful. The FAA Diamond Award of Excellence, we've gotten this award for 10 years in a row, soon to be 11. And what it is it tries to recognize the maintenance department or maintenance technicians for continuing education, which is something that is usually kind of an afterthought for a lot of companies. But for us, you know, the ownership and management has really provided and nurtured this program. Every year, we have 100% of our technicians that are eligible that will have anywhere from 12 to sometimes over 100 hours of training in any one calendar year. With that, over the years, we've averaged somewhere about 3,000 training hours every year just in our department to try to attain that level and get that award, qualify for it. And we've been successful in that endeavor. It's something that takes a lot of effort. It doesn't happen by itself. We have a commitment from ownership to get it done, and we've gotten it done for the past decade, and we will continue to do it every year hereafter. And you need to get better every day, you know, and this is part of it. This shows it.